Hey guys, welcome back to the Vino Rod. Well, today I wanted to show you a video, a tribute to the country, to the fallen soldiers recently in Afghanistan, and the flag. Well, rodeo is a big part of my life. Obviously, when I was younger. So sit back and relax and stay to the end. There'll be some rodeo action. Like it, share it, and pass it on.
To share our opinions about being American. There are people all over the world and media within our world that have taken choice. They've taken offense to who we are and where we've come from. There are people in our world who would like to strip us of those freedoms and change our ways of life. There are people in the media, and I'll stand responsible for what I'm about to say, that have distorted the views and values of America's past and have blatantly lied to us about our future. And with that, I take a new stand and a new fight to fight for the American way. This afternoon, I'd like you to think about tomorrow. How will you feel? How will you rise? How will you stand? How will you talk in defense of freedom and democracy? When you allow those who want to tear down our walls and build theirs and hold us and our families and our children back, will you stand and fight for yesterday's freedom that we all deserve tomorrow? And I hope it's the latter. This afternoon, as you watch this man campaign, bring this flag from 4,000 feet above us. He has made over 20,000 jumps in his lifetime. And today, he descends upon us once again with the colors of the red, the white, and the blue. Our cameras and the regular network for the rest of the world to hear and see are watching on their big screens as we watch him enter this arena. For the Elks Lodge, for the city of Santa Maria, for the neighboring communities, and the great state of California. Are you proud to be an American? Arena to present to you its final day to fly at this rodeo, but many flights beyond in days to come. That's why we fight, is to keep it free.
You know what, fans? One of the neatest things that I've ever seen is the energy that those soldiers just ran to that flag. To pick that flag off the arena floor and to hold that flag in reverence, because that flag represents and shines like a freedom of hope. Fans, come into the arena now on this Military Appreciation Day. We'd like to welcome the United States Marine Corps Mounted Color Guard, stationed from Barstow, California. They present those colors. We now welcome another group, the Vandenberg Air Force Honor Guard.
Thank you.
want you to think about something. As these brave men and women stand before you, they represent hundreds of thousands. But over the history of our American culture, over the history of this land, have fought and died for and reminded us continually that the freedoms that we enjoy each and every day were not bought with money or gold. But those freedoms were bought with lives lost and battles won. And fans, a lot of people are saying a lot of negative things about this land, about our country, about the patriotism that we are showing you today. But I say this to all of them. Despite all the things wrong with this nation, this is the greatest nation on God's green earth, period. What makes this nation great? It's not politicians, it's not celebrities, it's not athletes. What makes this nation great are the brave men and women that we honor today. The United States Armed Forces. What makes this nation great? Those 13 flags that represent 13 lives that just a few days ago gave themselves to protect the innocent. It is at our forefront now when we honor them. We celebrate them, we celebrate their sacrifice. But more importantly, we celebrate each and every man, woman, that has given their lives for this land. And fans, a lot of times they try to discourage patriotism. They try to keep our voice down about a love that we have for those men and women and for that flag. But on this Sunday, I give you the freedom to tell them, to tell the world, to tell everyone here that you are proud of the heroes of this land. One of the freedoms that we love is the freedom of speech, the freedom of prayer. We now invite you, if you so choose, to join Mr. Bob Tallman as he leads us in our invocation.
I have had an exceptional morning. I was a guest speaker at Pacific Christian Church with my friend, former neighbor, and our pastor, my friend Jim Blinds, in fact. Share my thoughts and yours as well about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You know, I'm big on Jesus, but I'm big on the freedom to share the word. You can do it. It's a God-given talent to speak about faith. And in our final day here this year, I'd like to ask you all to do yourselves a favor, and you'll do it as a favor to me as well. Tonight, before you go to bed, tomorrow morning when you get up, in the days to come, till we all join to do this again, strengthen your faith. You see, it's free. You don't have to go to church to do it. You don't have to own a Bible. You don't have to be ordained. You just have to want to. If you don't know how it works, raise your hand. Receive the Holy Spirit. It will come to you. You don't have to run to it. When it's received, you're not going to get a bill electronically or in the mail. You're not going to get any junk texts that say how good you are. But your heart will be bigger. Your mind will be clear, and your message will be true. To each and every one of you and your families, God bless your children. Raise them in faith. And until we see each other again, may God bless you all. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
We talk about those 13 men and women that passed away a couple days ago. Right now, I want you to think about something. I want you to think about a man whose military career began in 1942. I want you to think about a man that started as a grunt.
And after 22 years of service to this nation and the people of it, he retired as a colonel. Tonight, we welcome to the arena riding shotgun, thanks to Mr. Scott Parsons. He is a hero. He is a man that is 100 years old. He is a man that comes into this arena as a friend of this community, as a part of the Central Coast Corpsmen. But if it's ever crossed your mind to not stand when you see that flag, if it's ever crossed your mind to not sing when you hear the national anthem, think about this man, Mr. Dan Daniels, Lieutenant Colonel of the United States Air Force Space Force. Ladies and gentlemen, he is joined by his brothers, Sean Abel, Errol Collard, of course his son, Mr. Doug Daniels, Bob Carlton, Larry Long, Pete Bennett, Tim Flowers. Together they have close to 40 years of service to the United States Armed Forces. So fans, I ask you to do one thing, to join them and raise your voices to the heavens as they lead us in our song. This is our national anthem.
Stripes and bright stars.